Welcome, Manda. Vanakkam, Manda. Welcome to yet another exciting and productive interview on Tamil Suvai Radio. RJ Sudha here, founder and anchor of Tamil Suvai Radio. I hope all of you had a good Thanksgiving weekend and you're all looking forward to the winter break. I know, as an NRI, we have all lived in the US and who are all lived in the US for more than 20 years, getting past the green card issues and raising your children through kindergarten, through college. That was all a good challenge by itself. And then now some of you are looking forward to retirement. But then prior to retirement, there's one stage where set say your adult children off to marriage, just like how you got married, just like how your parents got you married. Some of your adult children, they probably found their partners at high school or maybe even at college or maybe even at workplace. But there are some adult children who are a little hesitant about, you know, approaching their potential partners by themselves. And they need a little bit of a push here and there. And at the same time, they don't agree fully with into the arranged marriage system. And for this, they don't gel well with this arranged marriage system. Banyan Way is there just to fill the gap. Banyan Way is founded by Aparna Bhaskar. She observed the struggles the first generation of Indian Americans or Indian immigrants face when trying to find a match for either themselves or for their adult children. She realized that missing the community and the family involvement that the Indian, what we had in India was being bridged was then started Banyan Way to provide a solution. Focus on singles of Indian origin living in the US and Canada. Banyan Way is open to all Indians, irrespective of religion, native language, and past marital status. We will be joined in this interview by Aparna Bhaskar, the founder of Banyan Way, and the chief relationship officer, Anu Ganesh. Welcome, Anu and Aparna. How are you girls and ladies doing today?
Good, thank you. Thank you for that introduction. We are excited to be part of this show.
Sure, yeah. Tell us, Aparna and Anu, I just picked up a few introductory words from your website, but then I'm sure you have a lot more history and the purpose behind Banyan Tree and about yourself also. Could you walk me through and walk the listeners through Banyan Way and about yourself also?
Sure, I'm Aparna Bhaskar. I migrated to the US in 99, so it's been long journey here. And as you mentioned, I'm a first generation immigrant parent, and my kids are still young, but seeing other friends who have older children and parents being worried about how can we be part of this process and help our children find their potential partner got me thinking about what can be done about it, what are the challenges. And I realized that we have a traditional way of finding a match, going to traditional route and doing all the vetting process, and at the final step the singles get introduced and they have to decide then and there, or maybe in a couple of months and get married. And children who are born and brought up here, they are exposed to a Western culture where there's no, absolutely no involvement of the from the parent side or the family side.
Right.
So I realized that there is a huge gap between the two and
two cultures, right? Yeah. What is expected from us, from the Indian, from the way we were raised in India, and versus what the kids from here are expecting from what a marriage should be, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So the Banyan Way is all about bridging that gap. And the main challenges that singles are facing here is they are exposed to a different culture, and they would the movies that they watch or the food that they eat or the language that they speak, all of that is like different. You know, they grow up listening to different kind of music and movies and everything. So they would like to find someone who's also grown up with a similar cultural background. Mm-hmm. So that's where the main challenge is. They hop from one mobile app to the other, or one dating platform to the other. And there's no concentrated population of singles, Indian singles, in most of these apps. There are one or two apps which are focused on Indian singles, and that might work for many of them. So in many cases, singles are also open to their family being involved in this process. because they are it's not alien to them that the concept of family being part of this process. And once they make introductions, then the singles still want to take it forward and make the decisions.
Yeah.
So that's where
a little bit of hand holding at the very beginning, and then once it is done, they can probably take over and then move forward by themselves. Yeah,
I wouldn't even call it hand-holding, just good intention, vetting and making introductions. It's like an arranged date, that's all.
Okay, all right, that makes sense. Any one of you can answer this question for me. Other than what you just mentioned, what are the other main pain points from the parent perspective and even the singles perspective in the matchmaking process that you have come across, other than what you just mentioned? And how are you helping them in their own ways, in their respective ways?
Main thing I would say is back in India, we had a close-knit community, which we completely lost when we migrated to the US. So the moment somebody is looking for a match for their son or daughter, the relatives, friends, neighbors, everybody starts calling and talking about, oh, I know a match, why don't you look for a match? And that network is completely gone here. And we tend to move around the same circle of friends. And if we want to go beyond that, then we need to take help from some third party, new platforms, new websites or new forums. And that socializing aspect is missing once we have moved to the US, because we have moved to the US. Mm-hmm. So that is one of the main pain points. Second thing is parents want to be involved in this process, but they're not sure how to be involved. So they're like, should I start talking about this when as soon as my children are started working? Should I start this topic? When should I raise this topic? Especially if they are career oriented, if they are studying medicine, and if they are 30 or 29, they get worried, like they are in their late 20s, should I start now, or should I wait until they complete their residency? So they have a lot of confusion. And back in India, we had our grandparents who would guide our parents. Here, our parents are not as much involved because they live back in India. They keep coming back and forth. So there is the first generation of immigrant parents are really struggling to find out the correct balance between letting their children take the decisions at the same time guiding them. So.
Very well said. Anu, would you like to add something more to this?
Yeah, I'd like to add one thing. So when I speak to many parents, one common thing that they say is, when we left India and came, we are still stuck, many of us, in the India we left, So when we come here, we know our children are being brought up in a different culture, but we are struggling, what do we follow? What is right for this, our family? So a simple thing like, our emphasis on education is so high in a South Asian community. So many of us, in most families, dating is not actively encouraged. Mm-hmm. So, you could focus on, your education, your career. Mm-hmm. And then once they finish, then we expect that they would have found someone already, hopefully in school itself.
Yeah.
So then, the singles tell me, how am I supposed to find someone when I never dated?
Busy at school, you expect
me to so busy.
Good scores. And then now you also expected me to find my partner.
So one thing, as so we have to understand, dating doesn't necessarily have only a negative connotation. It's socializing.
Yeah.
So that's all it is. So learning how to get along with, other people. So that's confusing for us. Do we send our kids to the prom? Do we send them to a dance? Do we, those challenging questions start early.
Yeah.
But we have to realize that, though they are from us, they have been brought up in a very different environment, and they are having so many challenges both ways. They are expected to be Indian, they're expected to be American, and yet one common thing I see in all of them, they long for a relationship just like their parents have.
Mm.
So that is a finding thing. And so we, Aparna and I, in the course of, these 4 years, we have enjoyed learning, about what these challenges are and how we can address them. And I think one of the key things is we encourage good communication between both generations, meet in the middle, find out what they want and are they ready, if they are, how to help. If they are not, you know, when is the right time to bring it up?
Okay, got it, got it. So either one of you can answer this question. And from what I've seen and what I've read, I see that two different types of events are being organized by Banyan Way. One is for the singles and one is for the parents. How are they different from each other, and what's the kind of expectation from either one of them?
Okay, so yeah, so we have two different kind of events, and they are for two different audiences. Okay. One is for parents, and it's called Milan. Milan, just like a meetup.
Okay.
So we used to have them in both these kind of events in person. Now they're both virtual. Okay. So what happens in a Milan event is parents in are able to, you know, join the event, register and join the event from anywhere in the US. So, you know, these are all parents whose kids were born or raised here in the US. So they can meet, you know, other families similar to them. And then we put the, place them in different breakout rooms, depending on the age of their single. So they can get to know each other, talk about their son or daughter, they'll talk about their family. So we do, you know, we do different icebreaker activities so they get comfortable with each other. So our Banyan Way hosts are there in these rooms to help them facilitate communication. So by the end of the event, Sudha, you know, they are really happy because they're not finding any other forum like this where they're able to meet other parents.
Yeah.
You know, living in the US for a long time, we our concept of personal space is a little different than India.
Yes.
Here we are more involved within our own family only. So we, you know, we're searching within a bubble. But at the end of the event, they feel really good that they have got some contacts and leads.
Yeah.
So this is apparent.
In the way I feel this whole concept of virtual meetup has kind of opened up the options for the parents and for the singles also, in the sense like somebody from California can meet up somebody from Atlanta maybe. Otherwise, it was more of confined within if I had a child in California, I think they tend to look at somebody in California itself just for comfort zone. But I think if because of the virtuality that is involved now, I think they will be more open to somebody outside also because of the technology involved and because of the virtuality involved also. Is that right?
Yes, absolutely. I think also post-COVID, or I mean, we're still going through it, but jobs have become a little more flexible. You know, people are able to work from home. And, you know, for a relationship which could, you know, potentially turn to something long-term, they're willing to give that time and maybe move temporarily or, you know, for the job so they can get to know each other. And also one thing, you know, just because we have all parents living in a certain state doesn't mean their kids live the same in the same state. So they may live somewhere else.
Yeah.
But when the parents meet each other and there's already a compatibility forming there, then the likelihood they feel that their children, when they introduce them to each other, they may get along. So that is the parent event. And then we have virtual events for singles. So this is for, we have events which are for singles who are born or raised here. And in fact, we have an upcoming event for singles who are raised in India or elsewhere. So these are, we do that so that they feel a cultural similarity to people who are raised in a similar, you know, situation like them. So those are slightly different. So, you know, those are one-on-one interactions. So, you know, they would get, 3 to 4 minutes with each of the other, you know, men would get to meet all the women for, you know, 3 to 4 minutes each. So they, in those few minutes, they can learn about each other, talk to each other. And so that has been very well received too, because they're able to meet singles from all over. And so they're not confining it to a particular, but at the same time, we have had some, geography specific events. We have had, you know, Bay Area focused event as well for singles. So we switch it up as per, you know, what they're looking, because we value their feedback a lot. So if they say we're looking for something like that, we will give them that.
Depending on the need, if you have more number of needs, then you expand the scope of the geography also.
Right. So just like we pivoted from, from in-person to virtual, so we are all, we constantly getting feedback from them. So they say they would like, so we have a theme for every singles event. So we realize that, you know, Bollywood theme is a theme for our next event. So that's something, you know, people would like. So we switch it up like that.
Okay. So you're talking about this in-person event, or whatever you call it. I know with this COVID, maybe it's minimizing, or we're still, some restaurants, most of the restaurants still have dine-in and all that. But do you have any in-person events planned?
Not at the moment. We're not planning that, at least in the near future, because we find that this way we're able to reach more people. Earlier, we were confined by geography to Atlanta, let's say, or unless we travel outside. So now this way we are able to connect people from, all over. And I think you may address this later, but we had, five successful marriages this year. And in that, two or three of them were across two time zones. So, why restrict yourself?
Okay, all right. Yeah, I was going to ask about the success stories. So you had five already this year?
Yes. Okay. So one of them met through a virtual event, actually. And the others were introduced in our personalized service, which we can talk about.
Very nice. Assuming that you have the Milan for the parents, and you also have this Bollywood themed or any kind of theme.
Yeah, it's called Hello. Sorry, I forgot to mention. It's called Hello Events.
Hello Events for the singles.
Yes.
How can the parents or the singles register for such an event? Is that through your Banyan Bay?
Yeah. They can go to our website, www.banyanway.com. And then there is a page for events. So they will see all the upcoming parent and singles events.
Okay.
So they can register right through there.
Mm-hmm. Could you just give me an highlight of what is the next two big events? What are the big events that are coming up?
Sure. So the next event that's coming up is on December 11th.
It's pretty fast.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, December 11th. And it's on a Sat. It's a parent event. And it's for any parent of Indian origin who has kids who were born or raised here.
Okay.
So it's going to be 2 to 5. I think 2 to 5 Pacific, which is 5 to 8 Eastern. And so the registration link will be on our website.
Okay.
So we highly encourage any listeners who would like to try it out. Please contact us. The Eventbrite link will have even a number for one of our team members. So if you have any questions, they can even call and ask. So that's a December 11th event. And then we have a December 19th event. That is a Hello event for singles who were raised in India or elsewhere.
Very good. Very nice.
Yeah, so it is for them. And so that is going to be, we are excited about that as well, because we have that in, every few months, not every month, but, every couple. So this would, hopefully help many of the people who moved from India who are working here to find somebody.
Okay, got it. So we have two types of events, and there are these dates may or may not work out for certain people. And what if some of them miss an event? Is there a way to catch up with either of the events?
So if they miss an event, the first thing they could do is, they could follow us on social media. They could follow us on Facebook or Instagram, and they'll get the updates of upcoming events.
Okay.
That is one way. Then we have a mobile app for singles. So if the singles join that, they will get updates as well.
Very nice.
Then we
what kind of updates will that be?
Yeah, they will get to know what the upcoming events are. What are the latest activities happening in Banyan Way?
Okay.
So that would keep them, updated of anything that we are coming up with.
Got it.
So we send a monthly newsletter. So they would receive that. They will know what happened the previous month, things like that.
Okay, that sounds good. Aparna, as the founder of Banyan Way, do you have any concluding remarks? Any encouraging messages for the listeners of the Mysore?
Sure. What I wanted to emphasize is that, finding a potential partner should not be such a stressful process, is what I feel. And our goal of at Banyan Way is to help them find someone without having to stress about it. And that's one of the main reasons why we have these virtual events, where at the comfort of their home, they can feel secure, and they can still get connected with a lot of the other singles sailing in the similar boat, and get connected and take it forward. So you just need one. You're looking for only one ideal person in this whole world, and I think it's just a matter of
it's being presented to you after a lot of filtering and stuff like that by Banyan Way. That's very nice. Yeah. Cool. Very good. Yeah, it should be a stress-free process, and you're making it very easy for them, right? Yeah, I agree. Yeah, great. Thank you very much, Aparna and Anu. I'll pass on the message and I'll publish this video to as many folks as possible. I'm sure there are a lot of people interested in this and who will follow up with more questions. Let's see. Good luck and thanks for coming on to Tamil Suvai Radio.
Thank you.
And thank you so much. Thank you.